7:15. We're going to talk, Hannah, with you for a moment about something we've been talking about a lot, haven't we? The cost of living crisis. And what do people do practically when they get in trouble? Who do they turn to?
And the thing is, of course, now it's not unusual for people to be telling us that they're struggling. Something that was once, you know, there was a lot of shame attached to struggling with bills and things. Now it's actually quite a common experience. Now, this month, of course, we're seeing lots of price rises really hit home. It could be your mobile phone bill, broadband, or your council tax going up as well. Yesterday, we heard that inflation fell from 10.4% in February to just over 10% in the year to March. But what that didn't show is really important. Food prices continue to soar at their fastest rate for 45 years, with food inflation more than 19%. And some items have seen even bigger increases. A 2-pint carton of milk, for example, costs us 40% more now than it did a year ago. That's £1.25, up from about 90 pence. With interest rates also at their highest for 14 years and likely to go up further, the impact on mortgages is also really significant. Many of the bigger banks are now asking customers to contact them if they're struggling. Our business correspondent, Emma Simpson, has been to find out about the help on offer.
In the meantime, as I said, I'm going to note everything that we discussed in terms of why you need access to the funds and that, you know, it's, you need to do food shopping.
They're taking 2,000 calls a day.
So you said that you get paid on Friday and until then you have no other sort of funds, is that correct?
Yeah.
Helping worried customers, that's all they do on this floor at Santander in Bradford.
You are asking for the release of funds for gas and electricity and food for your children, yeah.
And for other basic essentials too.
Nappies and milk for your baby, OK, that's absolutely fine. We can certainly have a look into doing that for you.
If you want a sense of the financial pressures people are facing in the UK, it's here.
OK, you're just getting a little bit stressed at the moment.
Hi there, you through to Max at Santa.
Max joined 7 months ago, having once been in need of help himself.
I started renting at 20 years old, 2 months before the COVID period. So I contacted the bank, I've been in their shoes, and I thought, I want to do that. I want to be that person that wants to relieve people and say, it's OK.
This is real life that people are dealing with day in, day out.
Meet the boss. He says the sooner people ring, the better.
People might be worried about ringing us, about ringing their bank if they think they might be struggling in some way, but actually it can only make it better. So if people are worried, please just ring us. We're here to help.
Are people getting into more debt?
We're not seeing that at Santander. So, yes, there are customers that are struggling. We haven't seen, though, a material increase in the number of customers who are falling behind on debt repayments. That's a very important thing to say.
But for those who do end up in a debt crisis, it's even more important to get help. Zach lost his partner. Unstable employment, unexpected bills. It all quickly spiralled out of control.
I didn't really understand how precarious life could be with, you know, not being able to afford my prescription, not being able to afford food for the last 5, 6, 7 days of a month, having to beg and borrow off friends. The sheer fear of thinking, what will happen? I've literally not got enough money to last.
The best thing to get
he now works for Sheffield Council and is a union rep. Last year, Zach went through insolvency proceedings with some free, independent debt advice.
You know, being able to go online, find help online, talk to people via WhatsApp.
Still struggling, but he's hopeful.
I mean, if you're stuck at the bottom of a hole and there's no handhold, you're not going to climb your way out. Someone needs to chuck a ladder down for you. Don't shy away from it. Bite the bullet.
The message, when it comes to financial worries, it's good to talk, whether online or on the phone. Emma Simpson, BBC News, Bradford.
Interesting. And Hannah joins us on the sofa now. What lots of people say to me and probably say to you is, I'd love to get through to my bank, but it's not that easy. So it's good to see this work being done, presumably not just by Santander.
Yeah, of course. We have also spoken to Barclays, who say that they have all their frontline staff trained to help customers offer what they call tailored support. I think that thing about contacting your bank, people have really varied experiences, don't they? Sometimes it can go really, really well, and then other times you're sitting there for what feels like hours. It is worth, of course, looking at what your bank can actually do? What are the realistic options for them to offer you? Obviously, it will depend on your personal circumstances. If you've taken out a loan from the bank, they can offer something that's called a part payment plan, where you repay a smaller monthly amount. On mortgages, you might have the chance, for example, to extend the length of the mortgage so that you're paying less each month. In the long run, you will end up paying more, but it can make the immediate issue much, much more manageable. Another way of doing that is a temporary switch to what's called an interest-only mortgage. There are other options like refinancing your debt, moving it all into one place, perhaps, to make the payments more manageable. I think talking about this kind of stuff is really, really hard for lots of people and not something that we're used to doing. But the message is very much that it is better to talk about it than it is to suffer in silence.
And banks have a legal duty to help you at that moment, don't they? So it's not like it's going to fall on deaf ears.
Yeah, certainly. And I think you know that if you don't say anything, then there's all kinds of charges and payments and extra things building up that can make it so much harder in the long run. Whereas they do have that duty, once you've spoken to them, to help you out. So it's definitely worth doing, as difficult as that phone call might be.
Just start that chat.
Hannah, thank you very much.
Thank you, Hannah.
Don't forget, lots of help and advice about the rising cost of living on our website, bbc.co.uk/news. You can find a section called Cost of Living, Tackling It Together, all the information. And just how people cope and who they turn to, who they can ask for advice or help if things are getting really difficult.
Yeah, and it's important to know who you can ask. One of the UK's biggest banks, Santander, says the number of people getting in touch for support has risen by almost 50% since last year. It's urging people to do the same. That's interesting, Hannah. They're saying reach out if you're struggling.
Yeah, we know that times are really difficult for a lot of people, and I think this month we're really starting to see a lot of those price rises hit home. It could be your mobile phone bill, broadband, council tax going up as well. Yesterday we heard that inflation fell from 10.4% in February to just over 10% in the year to March. But what that didn't show is really important. Food prices continue to soar at their fastest rate for 45 years, with food inflation more than 19%. And some items have seen even bigger rises. A 2-pint carton of milk, for example, costs us 40% more now than it did a year ago, £1.25, up from about 90 pence. With interest rates also at their highest for 14 years, and they could go up even further, the impact on mortgages is also really significant. Many of the bigger banks are now asking customers to contact them directly if they're struggling. Our business correspondent Emma Simpson has been to find out about the help they can offer.
In time, as I said, I'm going to note everything that we discussed in terms of why you need access to the funds, and that, you know, it's, you need to do food shopping.
They're taking 2,000 calls a day.
So you said that you get paid on Friday and until then you have no other sort of funds, is that correct?
Helping worried customers, that's all they do on this floor at Santander in Bradford.
You are asking for the release of fund for gas and electricity and food for your children, yeah.
And for other basic essentials too.
Nappies and milk for your baby, okay, that's absolutely fine. We can certainly have a look into doing that for you.
If you want a sense of the financial pressures people are facing in the UK, it's here.
OK, you're just getting a little bit stressed at the moment.
Hi there, you through to Max at Santander.
Max joined 7 months ago, having once been in need of help himself.
I started renting at 20 years old, 2 months before the COVID period. So I contacted the bank, I've been in their shoes, and I thought, I want to do that. I want to be that person that wants to relieve people and say, it's okay.
This is real life that people are dealing with day in, day out.
Meet the boss. He says the sooner people ring, the better.
People might be worried about ringing us, about ringing their bank if they think they might be struggling in some way, but actually it can only make it better. So if people are worried, please just ring us. We're here to help.
Are people getting into more debt?
We're not seeing that at Santander. So. Yes, there are customers that are struggling. We haven't seen, though, a material increase in the number of customers who are falling behind on debt repayments. That's a very important thing to say.
But for those who do end up in a debt crisis, it's even more important to get help. Zach lost his partner. Unstable employment, unexpected bills. It all quickly spiralled out of control.
I didn't really understand how precarious life could be with, you know, not being able to afford my prescription, not being able to afford food for the last 5, 6, 7 days of a month, having to beg and borrow off friends. The sheer fear of thinking what will happen. I've literally not got enough money to last.
The best thing to
get. He now works for Sheffield Council and is a union rep. Last year, Zach went through insolvency proceedings with some free, independent debt advice.
You know, being able to go online, find help online, talk to people via WhatsApp.
Still struggling, but he's hopeful.
If you're stuck at the bottom of a hole and there's no handholds, you're not going to climb your way out. Someone needs to chuck a ladder down for you. Don't shy away from it. Bite the bullet.
The message, when it comes to financial worries, it's good to talk, whether online or on the phone. Emma Simpson, BBC News, Bradford.
Really important to message to open that chat. Hannah joins us on the sofa. It's presumably not just Santander encouraging people to get in touch.
Yeah, of course. A lot of the banks will have their own versions of this. Barclays in particular told us that all of their frontline staff are trained to deal with people who call them up in particular difficulties and offer what they call tailored support. Obviously, what they can actually do for you will depend on your personal circumstances, but there are a whole range of things. If you have a personal loan, for example, they can offer you a part payment plan where you might pay a reduced monthly amount. If you were to talk to your bank about your mortgage, as another example that a lot of people are finding themselves in at the moment, they might offer you the chance to extend the length of that mortgage so that then your monthly payments go down. It is worth saying on that you would end up paying more in the long run. But of course, if you're struggling right now, then it's an option to get you through the next months or so. Another way of doing that is a temporary switch to what's called an interest-only mortgage. And there are all kinds of other options, like refinancing your debts as well, to help people in different situations. Talking about it is, of course, never easy, but it is the right thing to do and it will always be beneficial to talk.
And the banks have a legal duty, don't they, to help you out in those situations. Hannah, thank you so much. Really good advice there.
Thanks, Hannah. And also, if you need more help and advice, here's where you can go, the rising cost of living, on our BBC website, bbc.co.uk/news. Look for the section called Cost of Living, tackling it together.
Yeah, some really brilliant tips on there. Thanks for joining us. We're back tomorrow from 6. Enjoy the rest of your day. Time